Comptroller DiNapoli gives each of those districts a fiscal score, and the one with the highest fiscal stress score in the state is the East Aurora Union Free School District. We sent our Erica Brecker to find out why East Aurora's budget has been tightening. Erica, what did you find out?
Well, Scott and Kelly, I learned that this is something that's been getting worse over the course of 3 years. East Aurora's fiscal score in 2015 was 35. It more than doubled by the end of 2017 to end up with a score of 73.3.
Subjectively, East Aurora is considered a nice village, one with a picturesque main street and some large, beautiful homes. So it stood out when a state audit named the East Aurora Free Union School District as among the most fiscally stressed districts in the state. Business administrator Joanne George says the state's gap elimination adjustment hit them hard.
Our combined wealth ratio is high. It's comparable to some on Long Island.
That wealth ratio factored into how the state decided how much funding to cut from districts when gap elimination adjustment was imposed from 2010 to 2017. George said the district combated the funding cuts with reserves, and over time it caught up. Last year, the village voted to exceed the tax cap to prevent cutting teachers.
The community was very helpful in passing that. And that's a good place for us to start turning the ship around to build fund balance back.
During the same years that East Aurora's fiscal stress went up, its funding also went down. The same audit reveals the district lost 8.2% of state and federal funding between the 2014-2015 school year and July 2017. Meanwhile, the village's operating surplus at 2.8% is less than half of other Western New York villages.
That number would suggest that East Aurora is running a pretty tight ship right now. Is that accurate?
That is very accurate. Running our budget very, very tightly right now.
The second and most recent financial hit, according to the district, is that they received an influx of 10 high-need students right around the time that the current budget was adopted, so those students' costs weren't accounted for. Joanne George says the district is working on a 3-year strategy to rebuild its fund balance and continue making sure that spending is under control. Erica Brecker, Channel 2 News.